Good morning. I invite you all to please stand as we begin with our entrance song, and it can be found in the hymnal number 722, Be Not Afraid, 722.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak if you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you, all because of me, blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all and with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, Frank died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him in his eternal glory. on the day of his baptism, Frank was given the white garment that marked the outward sign of his life with Christ. We place the pall in the casket as a sign of our hope and prayer that he shares that life now forever with God. Let us pray. O God, who art mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Frank, for whom today we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, he may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Now I invite you please to be seated as we listen to the scripture readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth. For the Lord has spoken. On that day, it will be said, behold, our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Goodness and kindness follow me. of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will never die. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. I begin certainly by offering a word of welcome to all as we gather today for the funeral for Frank Cape. Note my prayers and sympathy, especially for the family members, friends, parishioners, those who knew Frank. Whenever a loved one is taken from us in death, we experience some sadness and loss. We grieve and mourn their passing. But yet, as Christian people, we gather here today not only to weep and mourn, we gather also to celebrate the goodness of his life, and ultimately to celebrate our hope in that promise of eternal life for those who know and serve the Lord. When I thought about Frank, I first thought, how do I sum up his life? 98 years. It's like, well, I could begin and, like him, maybe tell a number of very detailed stories, and then we'd be here a long time. that obviously he had a gift at that and was able to do that. I know there were several occasions that I was able to talk with him in different ways, maybe at a ball game or at their home or here at church. You know, that he often was one that was here early
And a little bit later, I'll talk about changes that he would have experienced, you know, from over his 98 years. Talk about a huge change. It's like he always had his seat, you know, right over here. And it's like you just knew. It's like, well, Frank would be there. You know, if not, he must be sick or away or something. Well then somehow with, I don't know, the changing of if he needed his walker or something, all of a sudden I look and he was over on this side. I mean, talk about a huge change. It's like, you know, those things like that. It's like you got your spot and you're just there forever, it seems. But so anyway, whether it was opportunities that I had to talk with Frank, whether it was at ball games or at church or at his home, occasionally I would be called to visit him, maybe to bring him communion or to offer the anointing of the sick. And even until near the end, I was always amazed how good his mind was. You know, times when I would go there thinking, oh, he's been sick for a while and this might be nearing the end. So not quite sure what to expect. You know, I'd go there and boy, his mind was great. And again, he could go on and on talking about things that were important to him. You know, his family or his days of playing baseball or ball games or just on and on. I mean, his wife, he would different times talk about Marilyn. And certainly some of the struggles with her Alzheimer's, you know, and other family members and things that they were about. Whenever I have a funeral of someone who was nearly 100 years old, I always am somewhat humbled and amazed. It's hard for me to even begin to imagine all the changes that they experienced in their lifetime, things that I only know about from what people say or what I read about in the history books. It's like he experienced that firsthand. Obviously, we continue to live in a changing world, yet we realize there are certain aspects of life, of things that are important, that will likely remain as long as there are people living on this planet. I think of things like the importance of family, of hard work, of having passion or commitment to things that one enjoys doing, about love and support for family members and other people. And especially as we gather here in church today, and as I think about what was important to Frank, I think about church and faith. Again, thinking of all the things that Frank has been through and experienced in life, I often think, you know, how did people ever manage and get through all of that? And it comes back again and again to somehow that reliance upon God. It didn't make everything easy, but it certainly gave them inspiration and helped them bear whatever it was to continue to have a sense of hope, you know, and recognition of the goodness of people and ultimately of life and of God. This week in the church, we observe Holy Week. And as I said at the Sunday Masses, we celebrated on Sunday, Palm Sunday, that this is the most important week of the entire year for us as Christians. It defines for us who we are, and it speaks very powerfully about the core of what we believe. We commemorate Jesus' last entrance into Jerusalem, first with great hope and expectation, thinking he was going to establish a new kingdom, the kingdom of God. But in a short time, Jesus has the Last Supper with his apostles, and he is arrested and led away to be crucified and died on the cross, the most humiliating and utter horrible form of torture and death. But for those of us as Christians this week, it should speak to us very deeply and powerfully about that incredible love of God and the extent that God would go to in order to offer us forgiveness and the hope of eternal life. I was drawn to the scripture readings chosen for Frank's funeral today. They speak about the importance of faith in people's lives throughout all times. In the first reading from Isaiah, we hear, "On this holy mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. He will destroy the veil that veils all people. And it will be said, 'Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us.'" So we think about that from Isaiah the prophet. So that's long before the time of Jesus. You know, but still they had the sense that somehow God was there and that there was something more than just life here. You know, it's brokenness, it's trials, it's times of planting and growing and success. But even beyond all of that, there's something more. And they look to God, to the one that would provide for them and offer them hope and the ability to rejoice always. So we hear about that from clear back in the Old Testament from thousands of years ago. And then in that second reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, he speaks about our earthly dwelling, a tent. And I'm always drawn to that. You know, when I think of people like Frank, maybe we think of our grandparents or great-grandparents or people of that generation. You know, as a kid, sometimes you get eager and excited to go over to grandma and grandpa's house and put up the tent in the backyard. You know, it's like, oh, we get to sleep out, and won't it be fun, you know, and exciting, you know, and so you do that, you get there, and then it gets a little windy, you know, or you hear a couple raindrops or some twigs falling, and all of a sudden you get scared and run in the house. It's like, this isn't very permanent and seems pretty temporary. Is there something more secure and safe and permanent? You know, and so again, Paul uses that image of saying that really our life here is like that. I mean, we know none of us is going to live forever. So it's like as we go on enjoying those things of life and taking care of responsibilities and things that we need to, Paul also speaks to the people of that time of saying we need to keep our minds and our attention to God, to that one who ultimately gives us that guidance and direction and that security of that hope of eternal life that the world just cannot not give. And finally, in today's gospel, it obviously is very fitting and appropriate in John's gospel where he talks about unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies. I reading that and thinking about that, it's like how many seeds has Frank planted in his lifetime, you know, or harvested or been involved with the farming, the cattle, you know, things like that. So for farmers, I mean, they just, I think, find that they have this great admiration and honor for the land and ultimately for God. It's like they know they can work and do lots of things, but in the end, there's a lot of things they can't control. And so in the end, it depends upon that faith and somehow God providing. And then as that goes on in John's gospel, then he also speaks about that idea of the person of this life loving his life or losing it, you know, of recognizing that has that seed that falls to the ground and seems to die, but through proper warmth and water and nutrients that it grows and produces abundantly. You know, so we also are called and recognize that like Christ, we are called to give of ourselves. You know, Lent and Easter and our Christian faith cause us again and again to think about how do we sacrifice? How do we contribute and give to others, which is so different than what the world says. The world says, just get all that you can and the heck with anybody else. But it's like we realize, it's like when we do things and give things for others, that there's great blessing in that. And it creates life and abundance of just goodness and joy. So as we gather in faith today, we pray for Frank, that God will forgive him of any sins he may have committed and now welcome him into that fullness of life and love in heaven. And we pray for ourselves. In a special way, may this Holy Week increase our faith and draw us closer to Jesus, the one who offers us true security in this life and in the next. May our lives be enriched by the goodness of people around us. May we also be blessed in the ways that even as we sacrifice and give of ourselves to others, we are a blessing. In all things, may we be drawn to a deeper union with Christ so that we can experience his blessings in this life here and also rest secure in that promise of eternal life and abundance of joy for eternity in heaven.
Please stand for our prayers. One of the ways that we as Christians show our care and love for each other is to pray for them. So we take a moment now to offer these special intercessions. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Frank, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, may he be raised up on the last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Frank, that he may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, especially Frank's wife Marilyn and their sons Gregory and Daniel, may all the faithful departed be granted refreshment, light, and peace with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and suffering, and those who care for them, may they find hope and comfort in the assurance that Jesus remains close to them always. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you please to be seated as the bread and wine are brought forward and we prepare for the Eucharist. Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Frank, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Now you can kneel or be seated for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Frank, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. As Jesus gathered his friends and disciples around him, they asked him, Lord, teach us to pray. So now at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin. and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. May again kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. As when the shepherd calls his sheep, they so when you call your family, Lord, we follow and rejoice. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come, give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. With joy. joyful lips we sing to you our praise and gratitude that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. Is not the cup we bless and share the blood of Christ outpoured? Do not one cup, one loaf declare our oneness in the Lord? You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. The mystery of your presence, Lord, no mortal tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot contain, comes in our hearts to dwell. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest wheat. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat.
A poem called Close the Gate by Nancy Cranhoff. For this one farmer, the worries are over. Lie down and rest your head. Your time has been and struggles enough. Put the tractor in the shed. Years were not easy, many downright hard, but your faith in God transcended Put away your tools and sleep in peace. The fences have all been mended. You raised a fine family, work the land well, and always follow the sun. Hang up your shovel inside of the barn. Your work here on earth is done. A faith few possess led your journey through life, often a jagged and stony way. The sun is setting, the cattle are all bedded, and here now is the end of your day. Your love of God's soil has passed on to your kin. The stories flow like fine wine. Wash off your work boots in the puddle left by blessed rain one final time. You always believed that the good Lord would provide, and he always had somehow. Take off your gloves and put them down. No more sweat and worry for you now. Your labor is done. Your home now is heaven. No more must you wait. Your legacy lives on. Your love of the land, and he will close the gate.
Please stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Frank may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Frank, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Frank again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation may disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
May the choirs of angels come to greet you. May they speed you to paradise. And may the Lord enfold you in his mercy. May you find
incense the casket or the body as the incense rises up, so that's a reminder how our prayer continues to rise up to God for Frank and indeed for all of us. Also, I heard a priest explain it some years ago that often the fragrance, the smell of the incense remains. So when you go and come back, you can notice the smell of the incense. So it is with people. They're taken from us in death, but in our memory and in our love, they continue to have some influence upon us. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Frank, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In peace, we take our brother to his final place of rest.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for light, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Tea.